Right, all right. How's it going, everyone? This is Jose Trujillo once again coming to you from Corner of Art Studio. And today, you will see me paint something awesome. It's been a little while since I've done a painting video. How's it going? Here's my trusted Starbucks. But nevertheless, I like to use that awesome word or group of words. I'm going to be creating something way cool. And today, I'm gonna do a oil painting. This is an 8x10 inches canvas board. Board. So here we go, okay? Oh, actually, let me tell you, because I haven't told you, I'm gonna do a painting of a bee. I saw this pretty cool little photograph of a bee, and I was like, let's do a painting of a bee. Of course, I've never seen a bee that close, right? But I thought it would be the coolest little thing to do. It keeps you fresh also. Or I guess it keeps me. That's how I see it, okay? I use one of these little pencils, drawing pencils or charcoal pencil. Use whatever you have at hand. It doesn't mean much, okay? I say it over and over, don't get caught up in the whole what are you using thing. You'll go bananas because it doesn't really matter what I'm using. What matters is that you use it, enough, and that you are able to have fun with it. I think that's really what matters the most. So, something like that, okay? That's the body of my bee. So, what was I gonna say? Yeah, sorry, I was trying to get in the zone, you guys, I'm sorry. What makes something so, like this simple, you know, because I hear people tell me like, oh man, you paint, like you make it seem simple. Well, it should be simple. I think that if it's not simple, you may be doing something wrong. I don't know. Think about it. I think creating artwork should be simple. At the very least, it should be, you should have some sort of gratification that comes, like I mentioned many times, that comes from the soul, you know, from that quiet space. I was listening to this awesome book called Relentless. I think the author's Tim Grover, I want to say. And I was like, man, this cat's talking about the same thing I keep talking about. Like, this guy's literally talking about the same stuff I'm always talking about. I'm always it's like he read my mind. No. But he talks about like the zone, but for athletes and whatnot. And I thought, wow, that's pretty cool that I hear someone else talking about that zone. I mean, I've heard other people, of course, I didn't get it out of thin air. But it was cool to hear someone talk about it. I don't know, maybe with such authority, I guess. That's what I'm trying to say. Anyways, here will be my abstract impressionist awesomeness bee. Let's see what this whole thing looks like. And, yeah. I paint in different ways, different styles, if you will, in different... I got stuck way too long in the same thing. And when you get stuck, it's like, I think it's very simple. I was taking I took my son to his first karate martial arts class. I don't know if it's karate, but it's martial arts. Some type of martial arts. And I listened to the instructor say something very cool. That one of the reasons why they do like a sort of like a screen, like a haya type of screen, when they're about to strike, right, with their hand or whatever. He gave the coolest explanation. I thought it simple, direct, and you know, right to it. He said, when we are dead, right? When we're alive, we breathe, and when we're dead, what, like you don't breathe. And you know, I didn't really think about it that way. Like, how interesting that as they're striking, they're inhaling and exhaling, and also they're, you know, they do this haya type of thing, you know, this scream to release the energy, right? I thought it was pretty cool because in artwork or anything, I think, it's very much the same way. If you are if you're trying to create artwork, or you're creating artwork or whatever, and you don't keep this flow moving, the tendency automatically throws you off. The tendency is to start thinking about it. And this is what I read in this book, Relentless. You know, when you're not in the zone, it's because you're thinking. And I thought, how interesting that the way to fix it is to stop thinking. It's challenging. Many people don't even want to, you know, they don't want to think not about thinking or something like that. I don't know. Not think about not thinking. If you talk about it, it's confusing. It's experiential. But I just thought it was the coolest little thing, you know, to hear someone else chant that chant. If you talk about it, it makes no sense at all. Because the mind wants to make sense of it, right? The mind's like, what do you mean? I'm not supposed to think? Nope. So what do I do? You do. Yeah, but what? You do. Like how? You do. It's only a matter of time, I think, a matter of practice, where you start getting to that place. I think that it becomes difficult not because you're not, you know, ready for that to go into that area, what they call the zone in anything, right? When you're creating anything, I think it becomes difficult because in the beginning, because we think we're supposed to do something. And, you know, let's do something specifically a certain way. But I think that the reason why it becomes so difficult is because of that. Because we believe we're supposed to do something. Aside from total energy and total focus on what's in front of you. Not what's in your head, not a scenario, not a, you know, just what's in front of you. What's in front of you in this moment? That's where you need to be. Anyways, I have to say something, you guys. I mean, I'm used to like talking when I do this video, so I'm not just gonna bail on you and not say anything. But I thought that book was interesting. I mean, I'm not trying to sell you guys the book. I don't sell the book. I just thought it was a cool book. I heard it from another coach. A guy told another guy that I knew this guy, and that's how I found out about it. I like to keep a... I like to read I used to read a lot of art stuff, but I like to read non-art stuff too, like non-art related, I guess. Because many times, like if I did that a lot when I was younger, I would read about art or, you know, the art process or this or that, and that's fine, you know, it's cool. But I would find that it wasn't really helping me, it ended up confusing me a lot more sometimes. And I used to like to read a lot about the kind of like the life of the artist, biographies and stuff like that. I used to do that when I was younger. But I started noticing something that many times I ended up confused when I read biographies, but when I read like art process or this or that, because it seemed like it was, many artists don't know how to explain this, and like how to explain, like what do I do in order to get better? You know, how do I reach that level or whatever? Many artists don't know how to talk about that. They don't understand the process of the simple process. It's not a process. The simple process of creating. Not that they don't understand it. I'm not trying to say, oh, only I understand it. No, they know how to do it, but they don't know how to explain it. And I think one of the reasons they don't know how to explain it is because they know how to do it so well that they never really, you know, sat there and been like, well, what's making it work? Kind of thing, you know? They're so in the zone that if you ask them, they're like, what are you talking about? Like, let's just do it. You know? So it's very matter of fact. I have this idea that good artists are not good teachers. It doesn't mean that everyone who can't teach is a good artist. I'm not saying the opposite of that. I'm saying that many times very good artists just can't teach, you know. Especially not teach the artwork, but teach the process. Like what, you know, like how do we go through it? Because it's something you can't really, again, it's intangible, you know. It's not something you can really put your finger on and say, there it is, this is it, this is what you're supposed to do. It's an experience. It's something that you find out. It's experiential, you know. It's like the kingdom of heaven. There's no science for it. Something like that. I'm not trying to be disrespectful to the religion or anything. Just say there's no it's like that. I think it's exactly like that. There's no science, you know. You can't really say there it is. It's very difficult because it comes through experience. It's not something that you're like, oh yeah. You do A, B, and C, and then you got it. You know what to do. No, you don't. There's no way. You cannot be taught that. You have to be shown that. And you have to experience it yourself, too. So that's another thing. I'm taking my time with this one, because I'm having lots of fun with this one. Even though in some other videos, I fly through them, and I'm like, go. And this is taking a little more of my time sometimes just to kind of show you guys that I am human too. I'm not just this artist who's like going bananas, painting super fast, which is, I don't find that wrong at all. That's one of the ways I love doing artwork. But it's just to kind of show you, when I do that, it's to kind of show you to not be scared of it, because there's nothing to be scared of, you know? If you're looking at this video for that reason. If you're not, well, you're not, you know, but I just want to, like, look. There's absolutely nothing to be overcritical about. Again, this is one of my awesome brushes. I think it was about $1 at a hardware store. This is another one of my secrets. I like when people tell me, like what brushes do you use? I don't know, whatever I can find. I'm serious, you guys. I really am. I'm not playing. I'm not trying to be sarcastic or anything. I really just, you know, let me see, let me try that thing. And then I'm like, oh, I like it. And I like it for a few weeks. And then maybe just to get it out of the way. And then I put it away in my arsenal. And then I decide, is that something I don't even decide. I think it's just like, oh, okay, this is going in my arsenal of awesome stuff. Just like that. So it's not, you know, it's not that, I don't know, it's not that big of a deal. Don't overthink the whole how this is done kind of thing. You know? I guess that's always my approach. Don't overthink it, because if you do, you'll miss it. It's so subtle that you'll miss it. Painting is I think, I don't know for other artists, but for me, painting is it's a subtle dance. It's a, and I mean subtle in the mind, not subtle. You can be fast, like sometimes I paint very fast, sometimes I paint very slow. Sometimes I paint in between, because it's a cool. That's what I love about this book that I was reading. It's a cool. It's not a nothing is forced. Nothing is forced. It's a cool. Something like that. That's one way of putting it. You know, it's cool. It's never forced, because if it's forced, then it can't be it. Nothing that's true, I believe, is something that you can force. I think in the beginning you have to do whatever you can, right, in order to achieve a certain result. But you start learning from experience, starts teaching you that it's a dance. I don't know. I think it's different for everyone too. So if you guys are doing something super awesome, like, don't listen to me. So, well, Jose told me to be subtle. No, I didn't. If you're doing something like super cool, like if you find your je ne sais quoi, by all means, keep doing that. Don't listen to this crazy guy. But if you're struggling a little bit and you're like, man, I don't know, like, blah, blah, you know, I'm just kind of trying to point to what has worked for me, you know. I'm really just doing that. I'm not trying to sound by any means disrespectful or anything to the process. Now, everybody's process shows up in different ways. Sometimes, one of the things that I will tell you, though, is that you're not gonna wake up in the morning and say, that's it. And if you do, you're blessed. I don't know. I personally don't think it works that way. You're not gonna wake up one day in the morning and go, oh, that was it, yeah, I got it. Because I just don't believe in that. That doesn't happen that way, because it's experiential, but not in the sense of a perfect scenario. Like, one day you're gonna be working probably, most likely, and it's going to get lighter, and then the next day gets a little lighter, and then the next day, and what I mean lighter is that it gets less difficult to think about it. And then the next day, and then the next day, and then on and on, and that's how, kind of how it starts happening. But I don't believe that one day you're just going to, you're going to wake up and go, oh, I got how to create this artwork. I understand what Jose was talking about. I got it. Or how, or whatever I read over here, whatever. I don't know. The reason why I say that is not to burst anyone's bubble and be like, well, you can't get it, only I can. No, that's not what I'm saying. What I'm trying to say is that because you have to create the channel, there is no, I just got it all of a sudden. It might feel lighter, but there is not that place where you're like, oh man, okay, I got it, I see, I know what to do, blah, blah. Because every day, it's an exercise. I mean, that's really what it comes down to, you guys. It's an exercise. There is no place that all of a sudden it's perfect. It's an exercise. It goes, every time it gets lighter, every time it gets better. It's like probably like lifting weights. I don't know. I used to lift weights a little bit when I was in high school. And I remember that for those of you who do physical training and stuff like that, or who know a lot about it, much more than I would ever know, understand that probably, you know? Of course, not probably, of course. You understand that it's not that one day you're just gonna walk in there and go and put all the pounds and be like, I got how to do this. See what I mean? That's really what I'm trying to get to. Like, I read so much about physical training that I was just waiting for that day where it was all going to come together, and now I completely understand what to do, and I'm going to go in there and I'm going to lift those heavy weights because now I got it. No, it doesn't happen that way, right? Anyone with any experience in that or in anything knows that, oh, okay, this is how this works. All right, well, do it today. And then tomorrow in the morning, or tomorrow, let's repeat it so it gets lighter. And then the day after tomorrow, let's repeat it again. And that's really, I mean, that's how everything works, no? So it's just, you know, one day it's going to feel lighter. And then the next day, and then like that. And it's going to be so much awesome. Awesomer, I guess. When it gets to that, when you guys get to taste the victory, I guess. You know, when you guys start tasting the victory, and you're like, oh man, I love it. It starts feeling better. It starts, I don't know, it starts feeling like, man, this is so worth it, you know? Anyways, you guys, I don't want to, check this out, bam, okay? You know why? Because it's cool to use anything you have at hand. Don't get stuck in it. Don't make that mistake. I call it a mistake. Now, if you have a very set, defined way of doing things and you're like, nope, Jose, you're crazy, dude. I only use a brush, or I only use a palette knife. Cool, don't listen to me. I'm not, like I mentioned before, I'm not an instructor in that sense. Like, I'll show you guys what I'm doing. But if you have something that's working for you, I'm just trying to stay here. Look, why get stuck? And you can use multiple tools. Create different effects. Some people, I remember some people telling me like, oh, but that's cheating. No, it's not. Why is it cheating? Why do we have all these ideas? Like, oh, it's cheating. We have all these stoppers, you know? It's like, no, stick to the brush if you're going to use the brush. Says who? I have so many people tell me that through my career, like. And then funny thing is that those people, for the most part, just kind of, you could tell it, a lot of times got stuck in their career or somewhere else. And people that never say that kind of stuff tend to be very, much more open, and many times have a lot of awesome experiences and opportunities in their career, whether it's painting or something else, because this it's not a matter of like doing it a certain way. It's a matter of what works for you, you know. What's, I don't know, you guys know how I think those of you who see me, seen my videos, I'm all over the place. Like, and then I come back to it. Just like, sound like a, what's his name? Bob Ross. You remove some of that, just slightly. Give it a little je ne sais quoi. Right? Leave some of that there, some of that is not there. I don't know. It's way too fun. There's days that it's not fun, but I still do it. It's not fun because the art is not fun, it's because I'm not being fun. But I still force myself to be in the studio. Sportsmanship, above all. That's really what. That's what makes the difference. And even the back of this. Because there's no book that says you can't. I love how you're using the Bob Ross blades. There's no book that says. The only book that says you can't is your mind. Oh, I love this. All right. Well, you guys, this is Jose Trujillo. And, oh, you know what? Before I, let's make this just lightly. The world's greatest living artist. Bam. Thank you so much for watching. Oh, hold on. Let me do a close-up because some of you guys love close-ups. Look at that. Look at that baby. It's about to fly. Bzzz. All right. Take care, you guys. Till next time. All right. Bye-bye.